I'm on Pornhub.
私はポルノハブに出ています。
Yo soy en Pornhub.
Yo salgo en Pornhub.
Siamo su Pornhub.
Nature is bisexual, not bisexual, bisexual, which means most plants and trees rely on bees to have sex and breed. But sadly, bees are dying off, and without them, it's lights out for nature's sex life, and no more fruits and vegetables for us.
Before the economic crisis caused by the pandemic, none of us ever thought we'd be saying that.
But now we're on Pornhub, we're experiencing some major growth.
Justo donde importa.
That's because we took advantage of Pornhub's
big package.
Big package.
Big package.
Big package.
Big package. Big package for small businesses.
Pornhub presents Be Sexual.
Hi, I'm Abella Danger. And my friends at Pornhub and I think everyone should be having great sex, especially when that sex is so crucial to saving the planet. Bisexual is a whole new genre of porn dedicated to saving the bees.
So a couple weeks ago, I did a video talking about Mia Khalifa and the corporate industry, really detailing her struggles to get her videos taken down, to stop Bang Bros and Pornhub from operating an account that is verified on their site, which makes it look like she is constantly uploading and she's active, despite the fact she hasn't actually made any content in years, because it gives people the impression she's active, so they harass her, they give her death threats. And of course, there's the infamous hijab video that she did, which has enraged lots of people. But in this video today, I want to take a broader look at Pornhub as a company. I really just want to talk about how they present themselves a certain way, and it's kind of easy to get away with considering they are a porn company. But then in reality, just like most capitalist corporations, they are very exploitative and they do lots of immoral stuff. And pretty much all the good things they do is just an effort to really disguise the bad things they do. And it's to really help with their overall image. So I think we should start with the good things they do, not to give them credit, but just to frame the whole video and really show you how these are really good PR exercises. But again, they are hiding something more sinister. So back when the pandemic started, the Sun US reporting, Pornhub donates 50,000 coronavirus masks to frontline workers and free porn for people who stay indoors. So Pornhub donated 50,000 masks to workers in New York and said it's given free premium access to the entire world as millions isolate at home amid the coronavirus pandemic. When a global human crisis happens, it's up to everyone to work together to help support the community, Corey Price, Vice President of Pornhub, said in a statement. And then Verily Mag following up with this, saying, in addition to the face mask for healthcare workers and porn access for quarantine folk, Pornhub also announced that it will be giving more funds to its models, the term used for people depicted in the pornography. During the month of April, the New York Post reports that models will pocket 85% of their sales from Pornhub and its sister site, ModelHub, when they would typically keep just 65%. Pornhub says it's also donating $25,000 to the Sex Workers Outreach Project, an advocacy group to support relief funds for sex workers affected by COVID-19. So that's all well and good. It seems to be doing a lot more than a lot of other companies. And they also have a page on their site called Pornhub Cares, and it really lists numerous campaigns like this that they have done. So I'm going to read a couple for you, and I'm going to play some videos of these campaigns. So the dirtiest porn ever. So the mass consumption of single-use plastic has become so common that we often don't realize how much of it winds up on our beaches and in our oceans. To help, please watch the entire uncensored video above starring outdoor porn power couple Leo Lulu, and for each view we'll donate to Ocean Polymers to help fund their efforts to clean ocean waste. So you can watch porn and you can help Pornhub give money to these, you know, groups that do good environmental work. It sounds like a good deal. So another one on this site. So Pornhub presents Bisexual. So Bisexual is a whole new genre of porn dedicated to saving bees. We turn short videos of foraging bees into what they really are. Funny, kinky, nature porn featuring the voices of your favorite stars. It's time to get busy.
The films feature the voices of porn's biggest stars, such as Brett Rossi.
His pistols are hung like a tree.
I know, right? I'm coming in for more. Let me slide in.
Tips on how you can help save our striped fuzzy friends.
So remember, without bees, there is no plan B.
So again, they're using this themed content to push something, but then they're doing some good environmental work on the side. So they also present themselves as a very inclusive company, taking numerous steps to make porn more accessible if you have some sort of disability. So Here's another story from last year. Pornhub ads closed captioning on websites. So as part of our ongoing efforts to make Pornhub more accessible for everyone, our new closed captioning category features an entire library of content geared towards deaf and hard of hearing users. Each video will display descriptive and interpretive text aimed to help improve the experience for users who are not able to hear the video's original audio. So another one from the same sort of date. So Pornhub optimizes platform for visually impaired users. As part of our ongoing efforts to make Pornhub more accessible for everyone, we will now feature enlarged text, customized color contrast, and keyboard shortcuts to assist our visually impaired visitors. So that is actually a really cool thing they're doing. And of course, it's better than things like YouTube. And of course, even things like YouTube aren't that good with stuff like this. So yeah, it's presenting itself, you know, environmentally friendly, very, you know, socially conscious, want to make it completely accessible. So they even wanted to help small businesses during the pandemic. So here's a quick advert they posted on YouTube talking about this scheme.
Big package for small businesses. Free ads on Pornhub to the tune of 1 billion impressions.
Exclusivamente para negocios pequeños por todo el mundo.
Como el nuestro.
Afinal, que lugar melhor para alcançar novos clientes?
De sito que recebe 120 milhões de visitadores felizes ogni giorno.
Talk about bang for your buck.
Inscrição é muito fácil.
Solo tienes que entrar em pornhubpackage.com.
And give some basic information about your business.
宣伝したい商品やサービスについての基本的な情報を提供してください.
E se sarai selezionato, Pornhub metterà la tua pubblicità sul suo sito a disposizione di milioni di visitatori.
Like this one.
Like that one.
O este.
O este.
O este que hicieron para mí.
So what are you waiting for? Sign up today.
So there you go, it's quite funny, you know, playing on all the sexual innuendo. And again, Pornhub is doing something positive. So they present themselves as a progressive company. And of course, because they're in the porn industry, it's kind of easy to get away with, even if you're doing bad things in the background. Because if you own a massive porn channel, you're going to have videos depicting, you know, every type of porn you can imagine, including LGBT porn. So it seems like you're already promoting that type of equality, but again, whether or not if the, you know, the top people at this company believe in this stuff, it seems to be pretty hollow, and at worst, it seems to just be, you know, a PR exercise. Like many corporations and many companies, they just do this stuff to market their brand. They don't actually care about any of these movements. They don't actually care about any of these people. It's all about just making money at the end of the day. And Pornhub and porn in general is extremely lucrative, especially during the age of the internet. But we've talked about all the good things Pornhub does, so let's talk about the bad things, and you'll probably see that while Pornhub may present itself as a socially progressive, woke company, just like many others do, below the surface, it isn't really much better. And again, like I said, the bottom line is making money. And here's something I didn't really know. So I didn't know that Pornhub was just one of many sites owned by a parent company who seems to have a monopoly on corporate porn. So an article by chronicsex.org said, "Don't let them trick you. MindGeek, Pornhub and YouPorn are bad news." And then it said they have a monopoly. So Pornhub's parent company, MindGeek, has a virtual monopoly on free porn streaming sites. These sites are modeled after YouTube, allowing users to upload content. Total, they consume the third largest amount of bandwidth, with only Google and Netflix ahead of them. Companies they own or are part of include, but aren't limited to, and this is pretty surprising, I didn't know all of this sort of stuff. So YouPorn, RedTube, TubeA, XTube, ExtremeTube, PornMD, PornIQ, Peepers, GayTube, Babes.com, Men.com, SexTube, Spankwire, My Dirty Hobby, Webcams.com, Brazzers, Digital Playground, Reality Kings, Mofos, Twisties, Playboy, and Wicked Pictures. So I guess there's some pretty big names on there in the world of corporate porn. But again, most people don't know the company that own Pornhub have a relative monopoly on all this stuff. And the article makes a good point that because this is like the Wild West, it's porn, it's online, there isn't much regulation, because if these were standard companies, you probably wouldn't be allowed to have this monopoly. I think a lot of you guys would have seen this really awful story I'm about to read you. It was making the rounds a couple months ago. So the title that the BBC put out was, "I was raped at 14 and the video ended up on a porn site." So last year, Rose Kalemba wrote a blog post explaining how hard it had been when she was raped as a 14-year-old girl to get a video of the attack removed from a popular porn website. Dozens of people then contacted her to say that they were facing the same problem today. So in general, as I read this article, just think of all the videos that are uploaded to Pornhub and all those sites I mentioned to you, which are owned by the same company, and then think about how much that stuff is probably exploitative, maybe involves minors, probably involves abuse, And because Pornhub doesn't regulate itself properly and because it exists to make money, it's really hard to often take these down. But to keep in mind, this case was back in 2009. So after her attack and abuse, Rose was browsing MySpace when she found several people from her school sharing a link. She was tagged, clicking on it. Rose was directed to the pornography sharing site Pornhub. She felt a wave of nausea as she saw several videos of the attack on her. The titles of the video were Teen Crying and Getting Slapped Around, Teen Getting Destroyed, Passed Out Teen. One had over 400,000 views, Rose recounts. The worst videos were the ones where I was passed out, seeing myself being attacked, where I wasn't even conscious was the worst. So Rose says she emailed Pornhub several times over a period of 6 months in 2009 to ask for the videos to be taken down. I sent Pornhub begging emails. I pleaded with them. I wrote, please, I'm a minor. This was assault. Please take it down. She received no reply and the videos remained live. The year that followed, I withdrew into myself, I dissociated, I felt nothing, numb, I kept to myself. Then she had an idea, she set up a new email address posing as a lawyer and sent Pornhub an email threatening legal action, and within 48 hours, the videos disappeared. And also in this article, Rose makes a good point, which I've been talking about in the video, so it's impossible to miss Pornhub if you use social media. They've done a great job at positioning themselves as a woke mission, almost transcending porn, but videos titled like mine are still on the site. There's no way of knowing if there are rapes in there and the victims don't know it. So of course, like I said, her coming out and saying this prompted many people to share similar stories. And in a statement to the BBC, Pornhub said, these horrific allegations date back to 2009, several years prior to Pornhub being acquired by its current owners. So we do not have information on how it was handled at the time. Since the change in ownership, Pornhub has continuously put in place the industry's most stringent safeguards and policies when it comes to combating unauthorized and illegal content. As part of our commitment to combating child sex abuse material, the company employs Voble, the state-of-the-art third-party fingerprinting software, which scans any new uploads for potential matches to unauthorized material and makes sure the original video doesn't go back up on the platform. But interestingly, and they made a good point, the BBC asked them, then, you know, why do you have titles that are so explicit, that play into, you know, these rape fantasies and everything, so that it's really hard to tell the difference, and it shows you're marketing to people who like this stuff. They like the violence. So when asked about this, they said, we allow all forms of sexual expression that follow our terms of use, and while some may find these fantasies inappropriate, they do appeal to many people around the world and are protected by various freedom of speech laws. But again, like I said, this isn't a really old thing. So last October, a 15-year-old girl was found almost a year after she went missing when explicit photos of her were posted online. Further investigation found that the teenager had appeared in around 58 porn videos uploaded online. Someone saying, Pornhub has been involved in a number of cases of sex trafficking and child rape, and it's impossible to know just how many videos are currently hosted on the site. So getting into more abuse that's been uploaded into Pornhub. So more recently, there were the case of 22 women who were coerced and manipulated by Michael Pratt, the owner of the website Girls Do Porn, into performing sex acts on film that were later uploaded to Pornhub. The victims in this case sued and won £9.8 million lawsuit against the company. So just to end this part, Rose makes an interesting point. She says, people may say what happened to me a decade ago isn't reality today, but that is simply not the case. Women have told me that it's still happening after they saw my blog, and these are Western women with access to social media. Of course, if you're from a poorer country or a poorer background, you might not have access to social media, and if you are involved in sex trafficking, being exploited by these awful abusers, then you have no way of knowing. And in general, of course, the black market illegal porn industry is extremely lucrative for a lot of criminal elements. Now, I made it clear in my past video, I'm not against sex work. I did get a lot of pushback of people saying that it's an inherently exploitative industry. And I say, as a corporate industry, I would agree. Pornhub is a great example. You saw their monopoly, you saw how they deal with these things. You see as well, which I talked about in my last video, you see how they use racism, you see how they use sexism to create marketable content on their site, which will get them clicks, but of course pushes extremely negative things onto society. And of course, in the cases I read, they kept up videos of abuse, sometimes after being asked to take them down because they involved minors. And just like many corporate industries, it's pretty clear that Pornhub and its affiliates use things that are damaging to society. They use things that are immoral to get traffic to their site and to make more ad revenue. Now, a lot of sex workers do support Pornhub, I think because for a lot of verified people, it's quite a good platform to make money. But it's clear that if Pornhub wants to continue as a mainstream company, and if it is indeed woke, then it needs to take down the ability for people to upload videos without much verification and stick to the people, I guess, who are like celebrities and have their stuff verified and checked, more like a Patreon format, I guess. But they're not going to do that because the current Wild West format they use, all of this gets an insane amount of traffic to their site. And as you saw, their bandwidth is only surpassed by things like Google and Netflix. If you're raking in this much money and you can get away with it, because like this person was saying about the monopolies, it seems the corporate porn industry is relatively unregulated, and it seems that it is not affected by many of the laws that affect more mainstream corporate companies. But I guess the general point of this video is that never believe a corporation is woke, because they'll often only do that in a certain region, a certain area, just to really get people on side. You see with companies like Nike, probably one of the worst offenders, pushing all this stuff about Colin Kaepernick and Black Lives Matter, which is of course very positive, and it got all those stupid reactionaries burning their Nike trainers. But then you find out that Nike shoes, although we already knew before they were made by poorly paid children in, you know, very poor countries, the labor has actually been linked to the Uyghur camps in China. So it's kind of hard to take them seriously. Of course, Nike have also donated to the Republican Party as well. But I guess you have to be more wary for companies like Pornhub, where on the surface, when you think about the industry they're in and you think about the glitzy, glamorized version of corporate porn, where these women can often get quite high stature on social media and can get quite a bit of money, when you think about that and you think about all the articles I showed you about, you know, the good work they do for the environment, helping small businesses during the pandemic, donating face masks, giving people premium porn, seems on the surface this company could be fairly progressive. They support equal rights for everyone, and because they're dealing with sex and sexuality and everything like that, maybe they are good. But when you really deal into it, when you go on their site and you see how their videos are titled, you see all the awful, you know, racism and sexism they push, and then you see how easy it is for so much awful abuse of minors to pass through their apparently good filters and get onto the site, and of course generate traffic for them and make them a lot of money. Again, if they really cared about ending this stuff, I would say you'd have to change your whole model on Pornhub to make it more corporatized, sanitized, steer it towards these verified creators rather than allowing pretty much anyone to upload whatever they want. And if it passes your checks, then it just stays up there until maybe one day, if it's someone who's abused, they see it and try and get it taken down. But as you saw in some of the cases there, that can be a pretty hard process. And of course, in the case of Mia Khalifa, which I made my last video on, she is still trying to get her videos down. She is trying to get her profile down. But of course, she is still one of the top stars on the site. And she still makes Pornhub and Bang Bros money because she attracts people to the site. And if they keep recutting the content and making it seem like it's new, it seems like she still does it. So they're still riding the wave of infamy she received for that hijab video. And of course, if you watch her interviews saying about, you know, she doesn't like leaving the house and everything, it's clear it has done, you know, irreversible damage to her mental health. Anyway, let me know what you guys think in the comments. Maybe like the video, maybe share it. If you want to find me on social media, follow me at The Kavanackle on Twitter and on Instagram. Please also check out my Reddit pages. So r/TheKavanackle for my subreddit, u/TommyCahill1995 for my personal Reddit. Also check out my Patreon in the description and my WordPress and my Medium. And if you made it this far, thank you for watching.